Some days you can't fall asleep at night. Some days you can't wait to go to sleep and escape reality. And sometimes you never want to wake up. The truth is, it is very easy to fall victim to modern day slavery, living your life to fit the needs of others and live by other people's opinions. We work so hard to be accepted by the people around us. That way of life is slavery. I've learned that if I do not value the opinions of people around me, that I could peacefully work on my craft and better myself while pursuing my passion. Chasing my dreams make me feel alive, keeping a goal so far away from me that I'm constantly chasing is what makes me feel alive. People say that dreaming is what happens when you fall asleep at night, but I think dreaming is what keeps people up at night. I'm not exactly sure what my goal is that I chase, but I do know that I strive to bring the people around me peace of mind, teach them a way of life that is pure happiness and success. I've learned the very, very hard way at such a young age, but now it's my duty to spread my wisdom. I refuse to fall victim to my past, but at the same time, I do not hide from my past. Instead, I learn my lessons and I use them for good. See, life is a yin-yang. There's always good where there's bad, and there's always bad where there is good. And it is literally a superpower to understand how to find that good in every single situation. Yo, what is poppin', YouTube? Welcome back to the channel, guys. If you don't know who I am, my name is Jake Dufner, and right now I'm kind of in a rush because Paul just called me freaking out. He swears to me that a clown was just at his house and he's running for his life. He said he got some crazy stuff in the mail. I didn't have time on the phone to be asking questions because obviously if something like that happens to your friend, you're gonna go as fast as possible. So I just picked up the camera now. I don't really know what I'm gonna get myself into tonight. I do have to meet Paul as soon as possible at the nearest Wawa. Hey, yo, before this goes down, though, make sure, if you are not yet subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on post notifications, guys, because we are going through the craziest journey I have ever been through in my life, yo. Every single video is just mind-blowing adventures. So join the family, join the Duffies, and without further ado, I gotta go meet up with Paul.
Yo, what is going on? Why is he... What are you doing, bro?
Yo, come on, hurry up.
What are you doing?
We gotta go. We gotta go.
You told me meet you at Wawa. You're not. This is,
I don't care. You gotta go. There's cops coming all over. Go. You gotta go somewhere safe. Dude, there's a damn bomb in that box.
What?
There's a bomb in the box.
Go.
You tell me you just put a bomb in my car?
Yeah, just go.
Dude, for the third time. I have no one to call.
Bro, why don't you just leave the bomb somewhere else? Why are you carrying it with you?
Just go somewhere. I'm gonna show you what's inside.
Dude, I cannot believe you're doing this right now. You should have just left the bomb on wherever you found it. You and your bombs.
I was bringing
bombs with you somewhere. Where am I supposed to go?
I don't know. Just pull over somewhere and we can look at what's inside the box.
Here we go again.
Let me go out there.
You gotta look at it. Just grab the box. It's in the back.
Oh my god. There's a lot more than just a bomb in here, bro.
Dude, listen.
What is this? Oh my god.
You're not gonna like it.
What is this?
Read what the note says.
Dude, where's the bomb, first of all? Is this thing live?
I think so. I have no clue.
It's not ticking or anything. Oh my god, dude.
But read this
note. He's got like 30 notes in here. What is it?
Read that note.
I don't care about notes. What is this?
It says it on the paper. That one.
Come find us, Paul. We know you'll bring Jake. Come and play.
We are home. Clown Town. Dude, he sent you coordinates.
Read this note now.
How many notes is there? Jesus.
Well, stop touching things and read that note first.
Okay.
I cleaned my favorite toys for you. The police are going to love it when they find my murder weapons.
Ah, dude, Paul, what are you getting me? You have to tell me this stuff. I'm touching all this stuff. I'm grabbing all this stuff, and you're not telling me what it is. Now my fingerprints are on it. What are the other ones?
Right here. That's the one you need.
Pay your friend a visit. Maybe we can talk with more coordinates. Why is he sending you so many coordinates?
All I can think of is when I first found that note, and I didn't want to say anything. the vents. Pay your friend a visit. There's only one person there.
Dude, we're hearing so much stuff coming from my vents too. Dude, you're giving me the chills all through my body.
Think about it. How could he have known where I live? I've been at your house. We talked. He probably followed me and then dropped the package at my house. Dude, that's me when I was a kid. Look at
all baby pictures.
All of them. And look what the note says. He wrote something on the back of that photo. Read it. No, you gotta open it up. Read what he says.
Walk away and you won't see your family in chains.
Signed Twisty.
Dude, you're bringing this a bomb on my car, dude. Why did you? Why?
Dude, we're in this. You brought Twisty into my life. I don't have no one else to call.
You should have left the bomb at your freaking house. Now what are we gonna do with this?
I don't know.
This thing gonna blow at any second. You know how many bombs we already had to defuse recently? We got murder weapons that I'm freaking touching because of you. And now you're saying that.
But if anyone else needs to be involved in this, it's you. Clown Town, where it all started. That's what it says on the other side of that one note where it says, come pay your friend a visit and we can talk. It says where it all started. On the other side of that note, it says where it all started. So I looked up those coordinates.
Yeah, there's
it's an abandoned house. I guess that's where Twisty started killing people. Those coordinates on the other side where it says pay your friend a visit. I looked it up while I was speeding away. It's your house. You're in this just as deep as I am.
Dude, you have chill goosebumps running.
How do you think I feel?
Are you playing a prank on me?
No, I swear to God. Paul, please tell me. I swear to God. You should have seen how it started. I was at the house.
Please just tell me you're pulling a prank on
me. I'm pulling a prank on you. I was at the house. I thought Anthony was pulling a prank on me. Twisty was at my house.
These coordinates showed my house?
Yes. Yes, I looked them up.
Oh my God, dude. I have the chills through my body.
I looked up all the coordinates already.
The first thing we have to do right now, go back to my house.
And figure out what's going on with the vent. And I already have that taken care of.
Why?
I have a GoPro that we can put inside of there.
Perfect. We're putting it down the vent.
Paul's got a GoPro that he's tying the rope to right now. Let me see it real quick. Okay, you got some Boy Scout knots going on there.
Yeah.
I like what I see. What we're going to do is we got the GoPro tied right there, and then we're going to lower it down into the vent that we're hearing noises from.
And guys, I realized that the vent that I hear the most noises from comes from my bathroom vent.
I just removed the casing of the vent. As you can see, this one's a little bit bigger than my other vent as well. So that's why I think this one's a little bit more special.
Bigger, meaning much more room for activity. Interesting. All right, here we go, baby. The moment of truth, guys. I'm gonna hit play on this GoPro and I'm gonna put it on the big display for you guys to see as well. First things first, just turn the bad boy on. I'm not sure if you're gonna see much, but it gets even deeper. It's a lot bigger after the first initial drop. I'm not sure what you guys are seeing right now, but I hope it's something. It's like far down there, bro.
What's like just dangling?
Yeah, it's like the rope is almost gone. I had like a 20-foot rope and it's almost gone already. What was that noise?
I don't know.
I'm gonna stand back up.
I'm not sure how well this is gonna work, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I think it shut off on me. It looks like someone cracked the lens, bro.
The lens is, that wasn't like that.
No, I don't think so.
Something cracked the lens.
Maybe someone's poking at it, like,
That's honestly tripping me out. Your lens just cracked, bro. This is not a game. Can the camera see that crack right there?
A little split.
There's like someone punched it, it looks like. That's weird. Okay, I don't know if this GoPro's gonna work, bro. What are we gonna do? Let's look at the footage first of all. Okay, so apparently, after looking at that GoPro footage, we could not really see much, which is unfortunate. I realized that it sounded like a really good idea to put a GoPro down there, but after realizing it's dark and it's not good at seeing in the dark, we couldn't really see what was going on. So the GoPro experiment was pretty much a fail. Now what are we gonna do, bro? Because there's definitely something in there. There's 100% something in there. Someone broke the screen on the GoPro after I put it down there.
Well, we know someone's down there, and we know that it leads somewhere. We have a tracker. Let's try to drop the tracker down there, see whoever's down there picks it up.
Yo, I completely forgot about that tracker. Yo, we still have the tracker that the CIA agents or whatever the hell they were, the elites, they put in my car. We still have that tracker. Yo, if we can do that right, bro, we could get that tracker and throw it down there, and where if it does lead somewhere, it'll fall all the way down to wherever it is.
And whoever's messing up, we'll pick it up and like walk around.
We'll be able to track it right to where it was.
Yeah.
da da. We still got the freaking tracker. We disabled it like a long time ago, probably like 2 weeks ago. But for some reason, I just had the feeling like, yo, I'm not gonna throw this out because you'll never know when I'm gonna need something like this. Or if something like this ever happens again, I'll be prepared. So I never threw it out, bro. And I'm so lucky, yo. Smartest thing I've ever done since the third grade. To be honest though, Paul, I don't think this entire thing is going to fit down in that vent, bro. The GoPro barely fit.
Well,
the GoPro literally barely fit. There's no way this entire, does this whole thing need to go down there? I don't know how this thing works because half of it is like audio, right?
Well, yeah, but
we don't need the audio part. We just need the tracking part.
There's probably a chip in there we could just pull out.
Okay, well, you're the tech geek. Pull out the chip that we need, brother.
All right, hold on. I'm sensing it's right there.
Oh, you're disgusting, bro. Come on. It's a serious matter.
Hey, yo, listen, man. I don't know much about this technological stuff. All I know is that I'm trying to catch a serial killer, okay? We're living in a serial killer's house, and that vent leads somewhere. We're figuring it out here, okay, brother?
You're wearing that hat? You're about to catch a case, not a serial killer.
It's a felony the way you're wearing that hat.
Huh? So Paul, do what you're good at and figure out how to get the tracker out of that device. Sorry. We're dropping it down there, baby. Let's get it.
Let's see it. Oh, you did it. How do we track it? After we drop it down there, how do we track it? On our phones? Is there an app? Like, how does that go?
I got it on my phone already.
Okay.
What I did was, they have the cell phone in here. Found out the cell phone number, logged it, and like, I kind of transferred it to my phone, and I'm tracking the cell phone number.
So you're tracking the very same cell phone number that was on there, but it's on your phone now.
It's on, yeah, and then...
And obviously it's linked to that.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, ladies and gents, it's the moment of truth.
All right, guys, Paul has the app on his phone right now where you can track cell phones. If you ever like lost your cell phone or anything like that, it's pretty much the same stuff. So here's the SIM card. What?
I plugged in the same number that's on there on here.
Okay, so perfect. Right now it's pinging, just saying that it's right where we are, obviously. But after we drop it down here, the goal is to let it sit for a minute or two and recalculate and tell us exactly where this goes.
Guys, this is the moment of truth, baby. Yo, I'm tired of hearing people just talking in my vents. I'm just trying to figure it out already. Yo, drop a like on the video if you haven't already for this right now. The moment of truth. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Hear it? That thing is still falling. What's your thing saying?
It's still in the same spot.
Why is it not moving?
Maybe he never grabbed it. Where is it down there?
Yo, what the heck just happened?
Did it go offline?
It looks like it's offline. It says there's no ping anymore.
I don't know.
Why is it offline?
Maybe he smashed it.
Who smashed it?
Whoever's down there. I don't know.
There's no way we can track that thing now?
Maybe. It might turn back on.
Is it? Maybe we just don't have a connection?
Maybe too.
All right, we're going to wait. We're going to give it a few minutes. If this thing doesn't come back online, I'm going to be very freaking upset because that's two trial and errors that just failed. Oh my God, guys, this thing came back on. We're in the car right now because we're mobbing right now. But we're right here. You see it says New Jersey there? We're over here. The ping? After zooming in and looking at the location that I'm not gonna show you because I don't wanna leak the address, but that is Calvin McGinley's house, bro. That is literally Calvin McGinley's house. We've been there 1,000 times. I know the address, and that's what's popping up right now. It blows my mind, the fact that somehow this all links back to Calvin, bro.
2,000 years later.
Here's the game plan. We're pulled up to Calvin's house right now. We just gotta walk up and then down the trail. Obviously, you guys know that. What I'm going to do is put this box of twisty stuff on Calvin's doorstep. But that's not the only thing, guys. I got a GoPro with 48 hours of footage left on this SD card. So this GoPro is going to be filming for the next 48 hours. I'm gonna set this GoPro up to where I can see the front steps of Calvin's house when he gets this package. The reason why I'm gonna do that is because Twisty is rumored to be part of the McGinley's family. He abandoned the family and they absolutely hate each other. So the reason why I wanna film it is because I wanna get Calvin's reaction. Set this GoPro up on like a tree or something like that. that so he doesn't see it. We got a microphone on it as well, so we can hear what they're saying. Stay there, stay there.
My God.
Dude, that was
such a close call. Oh my God.
My heart is beating through my freaking chest right now.
Dude, we were this close to getting caught.
You heard Calvin?
He was talking in the woods.
Dude, the thing is, if you guys haven't seen these videos where we go in there during the day, there's two houses next to each other. The one we just went to is considered his quote-unquote workshop, aka where he butchers little kids. So tomorrow morning, he should walk up and see that box. He must have been at his other house.
Oh my God, that was such a close call, bro.
I'm so happy we got out there alive, guys. I love you to death. Come back tomorrow and see what we got on that GoPro footage. We can always just go on my phone and check it out the second we get it, all right? So I love you guys to death.
Man!
I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one.
Deuces.